OAuth 2, there are two kinds of tokens. One is called bearer token. The other is called sender constraint tokens.
In the episode 1, I have explained that OAuth uses metro ticket-like tokens to access a protected resource. These are called bearer tokens, as anybody who bears the token can use it. If you lose it, and someone picks it up, she can use it. There's another type of token in OAuth. It's called sender constraint token. It's like an airline boarding pass. Only the person who is entitled to use it can use it. In the case of the airline boarding pass, the name on the boarding pass and the name on your passport must match, and the picture on your passport and your face must match. So, the token is bound to you. In an online scenario such as in the case of OAuth, this is usually done through a cryptographic key material. Unless you hold a key to prove that you are the entitled person, the token cannot be used. Because of this, such a token is often called holder of key token. In OAuth 2, you can use both types. In a simple low risk case, a bearer token usually is used, while in higher risk scenarios such as banking, a sender constraint token typically is chosen. So, now you know what bearer tokens and sender constraint tokens are.
And that was 2 minutes. See you next week.
Subscribe.